count on.
The city of Albuquerque has an entire department devoted to finding fraud, waste, and abuse. But when Target 7 uncovered that office costs you hundreds of thousands of dollars a year, we wanted to know if the department itself is a waste. Tonight, Target 7's Lauren Zakalik is investigating the investigators.
See this guy? He's wasting your tax dollars. The city of Albuquerque employee caught in this undercover video, appearing to do anything but work in the middle of the work day. Here he is at a car wash and here at a home supply store. The man tracked, traced, and trailed, not by the city, but by a private investigator.
That's a shock that they're doing and handling that many cases.
That's right. The city farmed out hundreds of investigations last year, even though it has its own investigators. The Inspector General's office investigates waste, abuse, and fraud within the city. Here's City Councilor Ken Sanchez.
Well, I think it's a very, very important role in the city of Albuquerque.
Important, perhaps, in theory, but in practice, Target 7 has discovered that's a different story.
You see, in 2012, the IG's office got about $320,000 in funding. That's your tax dollars. For that, they pumped out only nine investigations, costing you on average $35,000 a pop. The last one they completed was back in June. We've also discovered that Robert Caswell Investigations, or RCI, a private investigation firm, was also paid about $328,000 last year to do investigations for the city. In fact, they're the ones who did the recon on this rogue city employee we showed you earlier. But for that money, RCI performed 172 investigations for the city. If you're keeping score at home, that's $2,000 a case versus the city's $35,000. Former APD officers Bob Caswell and Bob Casey, who run RCI, are the ones giving the city more bang for your buck.
We've tried to develop efficiencies in what it takes to do these cases.
The numbers were a big eye-opener for City Attorney David Torek.
Did these numbers surprise you?
Yeah.
Why?
It's just the numbers in terms of dollar amounts, no. The numbers in terms of productivity, yes.
And Torek says last year he even asked the Inspector General to look into more cases, and they rejected some of his requests. But there seems to be a disconnect, because Councilor Sanchez believes the problem is the city isn't giving the investigator's office enough work.
Are taxpayers getting ripped off?
If they were given the opportunity to do their job, I don't think that would be the case.
But it all seems to beg the question, is this office even worth your tax dollars? Well, that answer lies here at City Council. City councilors are the only ones with the power to either dissolve the office or even cut its funding. So we went to get some answers for you.
If they're not effective, absolutely not effective, then we should be willing to make the changes that are necessary.
Every single city councilor we spoke to agreed taxpayers are not getting a good deal right now. But they differ on how to fix that.
Is dissolving the office a possibility?
Everything's a possibility.
I think we need to have the Inspector General. We just need to improve it.
300 some thousand a year is a small price to pay for transparency.
And Councilor Sanchez goes a step further even, saying the office needs more money.
The IG can do their job if they're given enough resources to do their job.
In your eyes, getting rid of the IG's office would never be an option.
I think it would be a huge mistake.
Some of the councilors tell us because we brought this information to their attention, this issue may be brought up at council in the coming weeks. As for the acting Inspector General himself, he declined to comment for our story. For Target 7, I'm Lauren Zakalik.
Some city councilors wanted to make sure it's clear. One big reason they support the office is because it is completely independent and does not have to answer to the city, even though the city funds it. According to online documents, the Inspector General's office completed 8 investigations in 2011 and 5 in 2000.